In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord of mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ of mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, by whose gift your faithful offer you right and praiseworthy service, grant, we pray, that we may hasten without stumbling to receive the things you have promised. So, our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. In your sight, Lord, the whole world is like a grain of dust that tips the scales, like a drop of morning dew falling on the ground. Yet you are merciful to all because you can do all things and overlook men's sins so that they can repent. Yes, you love all that exists. You hold nothing of what you have made in abhorrence, for had you hated anything, you would not have formed it. And how, had you not willed it, could a thing persist? How be conserved if not called forth by you? You spare all things, because all things are yours, Lord, lover of life, you whose imperishable spirit is in all. Little by little, therefore, you correct those who offend. You admonish and remind them of how they have sinned, so that they may abstain from evil and trust in you, Lord. The word of the Lord. I will bless your name forever, O God, my King. I will bless your name forever, O God, my King. I will give you glory, O God, my King. I will bless your name forever. I will bless you day after day and praise your name forever. I will bless your name forever, O God, my King. The Lord is kind and full of compassion, slow to anger, abounding in love. How good is the Lord to all, compassionate to all his creatures. I will bless your name forever, O God, my King. All your creatures shall thank you, O Lord, and your friends shall repeat their blessing. They shall speak of the glory of your reign and declare your might, O God. I will bless your name forever, O God, my King. The Lord is faithful in all his words and loving in all his deeds. The Lord supports all who fall and raises all who are bowed down. I will bless your name forever, O God, my King. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We pray continually that our God will make you worthy of his call, and by his power fulfill all your desires for goodness, and complete all that you have been doing through faith. Because in this way, the name of our Lord Jesus Christ will be glorified in you and you in him by the grace of our God and the Lord Jesus Christ. To turn now, brothers, to the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and how we shall all be gathered round him. Please do not get excited too soon or alarmed by any prediction or rumour or any letter claiming to come from us, implying that the day of the Lord has already arrived. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Please stand to greet the gospel. God loved the world so much that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus entered Jericho and was going through the town when a man whose name was Zacchaeus made his appearance. He was one of the senior tax collectors and a wealthy man. He was anxious to see what kind of man Jesus was, but he was too short and could not see him for the crowd. So he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore tree to catch a glimpse of Jesus, who was to pass that way. When Jesus reached the spot, he looked up and spoke to him. "Zacchaeus, come down. Hurry, because I must stay at your house today." And he hurried down and welcomed him joyfully. They all complained when they saw what was happening. "He has gone to stay at a sinner's house," they said. But Zacchaeus stood his ground and said to the Lord, "Look, sir, I am going to give half my property to the poor, and if I have cheated anybody, I will pay him back four times the amount." And Jesus said to him, "Today salvation has come to this house, because this man too is a son of Abraham. For the Son of Man has come to seek out and save what was lost." The Gospel of the Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. St. Luke portrays Jesus as the one who comes to seek the lost and save the sinner. And in today's gospel, he fulfills that role in a powerful and graphic way. We are told that Jesus noticed Zacchaeus perched up in the tree. He spoke with him, he befriended him, and he asked him to come down. Then, much to the disbelief of the crowd, Jesus said, "Hurry, I must stay at your house today." The story of Zacchaeus is a very familiar one for us. Many of you would know it from when you or your children were preparing for the sacrament of first penance. I'm afraid Zacchaeus has got his P45 from that job in favor of the good shepherd and the lost sheep. Because of political correctness, catechists felt that Zacchaeus needed to leave the stage. After all, he was a little person. He was a dwarf. And they felt that it was better to move away from that image in case it might be controversial. However, Zacchaeus has a lot to teach us about how we welcome Jesus. And I think the following reflection is a useful one. If Jesus came to your house to spend some time with you, if he came unexpected, I wonder what you'd do. Oh, I'd know you'd give your nicest room to such an honored guest, and all the food you'd give to him would be the very best. And you would keep assuring him you're glad to have him there, that serving him in your home is joy beyond compare. But when you saw him coming, would you meet him at the door, or would you have to change your clothes before you let him in, or hide some magazines and put the Bible where they'd been. And I wonder if the Saviour spent a day or two with you, would you go right on doing the things you always do? Would you go right on saying the things you always say? Or would life for you continue as it does from day to day? Would you take Jesus with you everywhere you go? Or would you maybe change your plans for just a day or so? Would you be glad to have him meet your closest friends? Or would you hope they'd stay away until his visit ends? Would you be glad to have him stay forever on and on? Or would you sigh with great relief when he at last was gone? It might be interesting to know the things that you would do if Jesus came in person to spend some time with you. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Amen. Now we stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Jesus entered the home of Zacchaeus the sinner and brought salvation to his house. He offers the same gift to each of us as he enters our hearts today. So let us bring our petitions to him in a spirit of confident trust that he will answer all our needs.
We pray for the church and especially for our own parish community as we struggle together to be living witness to Christ's presence in our midst. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We ask that God may make us worthy of the life he has called us to live, and that it will be expressed in the love and the care that we show to all who cross our paths on a daily basis, especially to the members of our own families. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
In today's gospel story, we hear how Zacchaeus was prepared to make amends to all the people in his life whom he may have hurt. May we look into our lives and do likewise. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We remember those who are most in need of our prayers, the sick, the lonely, the poor, and those who have lost their way. May we be open to assisting them in whatever way we can. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for peace in our world, that nations will be reconciled with one another. We remember in particular refugees and displaced people whose misery is compounded by the onset of winter. Lord,
Lord, graciously hear us. And we pray for all our own intentions. Lord, hear us. And we pray for all who have died the recently deceased Brian Mackey, Aaron O'Neill, and Patrick Ward of South Street, who died on Friday, and his funeral mass will be on Wednesday at noon in Clog Chapel in Newry. At this time, we remember Gordon McLean, James Lappin, Kathleen Patrick, and Brendan McConville. Yesterday was the first anniversary of Philomena Hoy, and the anniversaries of John Jordan, Mao Lacha and Sarah Mao, Mao Lacha and B. Cola, Francisco Victor Tavares, and Hugo Pereira. Today, the first anniversary of Molly Murphy, and the anniversaries of Maria Tomasia Vasconcelos, Dr. Raymond Fleming, Teresa McCaffrey, Rosaline Judge, Patrick Hippany, Kathleen Keegan, Ernest Elliott, Ayrton Ibar de Cunha Pereira de Mota. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, renew once again the hearts of your faithful as you enter our homes. May there be places free from conflict and full of peace and joy that only you can give. Through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, become for you a pure oblation and for us a holy outpouring of your mercy. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Amen. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Amen. indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Eamon, our Bishop, Assistant Bishop Michael, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, our venerable spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Let us pray. May the working of your power, O Lord, increase in us, we pray, so that renewed by these heavenly sacraments, we may be prepared by your gift for receiving what they promise. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Last week's collection amounted to £1,753.22. The standing order for the month, £967. And again, thank you to all who contributed. November, we're heading there, and the Mass of Remembrance for our deceased loved ones will take place on Wednesday, the 2nd of November, here in St. John's at 7 p.m. Mass time for the Feast of All Saints, Tuesday, Holy Day of Obligation. Monday evening, Vigil Mass in St. Patrick's at 7. Tuesday, 10 a.m. in St. Patrick's and 7 p.m. here. And Wednesday, the Feast of All Souls, as there will be 10 a.m. in St. Patrick's as well as the Mass of Remembrance at 7 p.m. here. And there will be a collection for the Central Diocesan Fund at all those Masses on Wednesday. It's a blue envelope. November dead lists are still available at the rear of the church, and grave candles can also be made available. Exposition of the Blessed Sacrament in St. Patrick's will take place after the 10 o'clock Mass this Friday, the first Friday, St. Patrick's, until 12:30 p.m. from after Mass time. And Priest Drew's collection will take place next weekend, the 5th and the 6th of November, pink envelope, and the usual white envelope for the usual, the weekly collection will also be taken. PALS are looking for volunteers. If you're over 18 interested in volunteering for the PALS Children's Liturgy, please come along to a meeting in the Pastoral Centre on Wednesday, the 9th of November at 7:30. That's the 9th of November. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended.